work like butcher.
Oh, my happy!
And you never knew about me.
you come up and join us? Oh, now, that's not a very pretty way to talk. Oh, hang up on it, Eva. The landlord breaks, phoning from downstairs.
What's all this going on in the dining room, Mr. Auburn?
Just a gay little party.
Getting married.
Oh, we simply mustn't tell her we're married yet.
But we're off on our honeymoon to Niagara The deuce with Aunt Pen and her money. This is our bridal night.
Oh, no, George, you must be brave and take me home. Yes, George, now where's my bag?
Oh, leave your little bag here, sweetie, and then we can get away at a moment's notice.
All right, but first I'm going to take out my picture of my George. Oh, I'm going to sleep in your dear face right beside me tonight.
Oh, darling.
Oh, no.
Yes, what's the matter, precious?
Your pajamas.
Oh, there's your
incurable grouch is all right. That landlord has about as a genial disposition as a snapping turtle.
Oh, what a shame.
Yes, isn't it?
Hey, kids, guess what? What?
Now, Jim, you've got to have those girls out of here in 5 minutes. You heard what he said.
All right, all right.
Then have them go down the kitchen stairs.
What?
I'm going out myself in a few minutes, and I don't want to meet any of them on the way.
Afraid you might have to see one of them home, I suppose. You're a darn fine host.
I'm not the host, you're the host.
I know. We'll invite the little dears to go around with us to the country club tomorrow. That might soften the abruptness of their being literally thrown out now.
I'm not going to the country club.
Oh, yes, you are. Why, tomorrow I'm to be presented with the polo trophy. Rah, rah, rah. Besides, the celebrated judge is going to make a speech.
I hate speeches.
But this old Johnny is the finest academic speaker I ever heard.
Yes?
Yes. He always says, waiter, give that check to me.
Together in the good old times.
had a crust, all right.
He told me to call him the Toodles. Pet name, you know.
I imagine the Toodles have been taking a long, lingering lap at the wine when it was red.
Yes, he had. He stood up on the table and started to read his speech. He said he was going to deliver and some function tomorrow. He'd only just begun when the policeman came in and told him he'd have to pipe down.
And that big Toodle saw
it. Oh, did it? He turned the policeman around and kicked him.
And that made the policeman sore.
Oh, he was terrible. He mixed up. The policeman caught hold of me and then I hit him. And then I broke away and the policeman after me. Oh, fortunately somebody tripped him up when he fell.
Not the policeman's lucky night.
Oh, I lost my head. All I could think of was how to escape. I ran and ran and ran. And then I saw the fire escape and this window open, and so I just climbed on in. Which is really hard to do with these high windows, you know.
For you. Oh, now please don't go. But why the busy Bertha?
What? All this? Oh, you know, I don't know. I guess I must have picked it up when the policeman fell, though I don't remember doing it.
Don't you think you'd better give that to me? You don't need to hold the gun on me. Why, any scrap you get into, you can count on my co-op. Jim Marvin is my name. Jimmy to my friends.
Mine is Jackie Sampson.
Well, how do you do, Jackie?
How do, Jim?
Jimmy.
Jimmy.
Here, let me take your rap for you.
Oh, thank you.
Jackie Sampson. Now, that sounds familiar.
Oh, yes. I'm in the new novelty play at the Kingston Live Scene this week. I play Modesty.
Must be a damn fine actress.
I beg your pardon.
Why? Have you got a description?
No. But I got a purse.
With her name in it?
I'll be back later.
Take my advice and give a little beefsteak party to that injured optic.
I'm gonna hang around outside and watch.
No use, Constable. Sometimes Mr. Bud stays out all night.
Oh, jeez, I wish I'd bring my wife to let me do that.
I didn't know you were married.
Oh, I'm one of them close-minded fellas. I keep my troubles to myself.
My bag! He has my bag!
You've been listening. Did you hear what I said about Mrs. George Bud? Pretty brainy work, by God.
Yes, my bag. What shall I do now? What shall I do now?
Well, was there anything much in your bag?
Anything much? $500, two diamonds, double garter clasps, a vanity case, 200 cigar store coupons, a copy of What a Young Girl Should Know, and worst of all, a rabbit's foot.
A rabbit's foot?
Oh, a rabbit that was shot in full bone in a churchyard.
Great Scott! Are you superstitious?
Why do you always abbreviate the words?
Oh, just a half.
I do hate to lose that rabbit's foot.
Well, don't worry. I'll get that bag for you if I have to break into jail and steal it. Now, I'm going to go down to the inn to see if I can find out who Toodles is.
Well, yes, but how will that help us?
Well, it was Toodles' fault that you got mixed up in this scrimmage. And if I can make him come forward like a man and take the blame, he can clear you.
Oh, you're an awfully good sort to take all this trouble from somebody you don't even know.
Oh, I feel as if I know you all my life.
Funny, I do too.
Perhaps we met before.
Perhaps.
When I was a king in Babylon, and you were a Christian slave.
Babylon? Oh, I've never been in that part of Long Island before.
Well, we've met this time, and we're going to be pals.
That's it.
You are such a pal, don't know, never shall. Why, you have distance, all other women in existence. If you only knew how I long for you, I never thought you would ever come. What love that brought you? Some sort.
set the alarm for 9 o'clock. Might as well talk to a blooming sphinx.
Who was that?
George's man, Briggs. He only comes in by day.
Oh, are you going down to the inn now?
Yes.
What shall I do?
You stay here.
Well, how long?
All night. It's raining. Besides, Sims is hanging around downstairs. He'd be suspicious if you went out now.
Well, yes, but where shall I sleep?
In George's room.
In George's room? And where is George?
George went out to get away from some girls I had up here. Hates girls, George does.
Oh, you mean he's coming back?
Yes. But George, tell him that he's to come over to my place and sleep on the sofa.
Oh, I see. And he won't object?
Not a bit. You know, I saved his life once.
Oh.
And if he puts up a kick, just remind him of it. Oh, by the way, Jackie, are you hungry?
Oh, no, but... I'm dreadfully tired.
Well, turn in and make yourself comfy. George may be very late.
It's a funny experience, sitting up for a husband.
Yes, I wish you were sitting up for me. I mean, if you were my wife, you wouldn't have to wait for me. I'd never leave you. I'd never, ever, ever. I'd better go down to the inn or else it'll be closed. I'll pop around in the morning and report my progress in a search for Tootles.
Oh, thank you.
I'm going down the back way, so see if you won't see me.
All right.
Good night.
Good night, Jimmy. Shock to you. But Jimmy. Mr. Martin said you were.
Did this inspiration strike him before he followed the horsehair sofa or afterwards?
No, you see, he saved the situation when the policeman insisted upon searching the place by saying that I was Mrs. Bodden.
Great Scott!
Well, you're not angry.
Not at you, but I'd like to wring Jim Martin's neck.
Oh, now don't you forget, he saved your life once. He told me to remind you of it.
Oh, he did?
Yes. And he said for that reason, you would do your best to protect me. Please.
That's right. I must respect the obligation.
I knew you would. Oh, by the way, I hope you don't mind my wearing your pajamas.
My pajamas?
Yes, aren't they yours?
Well, in a sort of way, they are mine.
A sort of way?
Well, you see, I don't wear them myself.
Georgie! Ooh, I don't think Jimmy knows you as well as he thinks he does.
Oh, really, it's nothing like that. Really, that you don't understand.
Well, good evening, Georgie. Hope I ain't butting in. Oh, gave you a start, did I, Missy? You seem kind of scared.
Well, naturally, frightened me seeing a strange man walk in like that. Ask him what he means by intruding on our privacy. Darling.
No. Mr. Butler.
What name?
Carter, Judge Carter.
I'm afraid, sir, he's still in the arms of Morpheus.
We'll get him out of them right away.
Yes, sir. Won't you please sit down? Mr. Butler, there's a gentleman out here who would rather like to see you.
Who insists on seeing you?
Who insists on seeing you? Do you wish the gentleman to come in?
He's a mighty sound sleeper.
He's sleeping.
What do you mean?
Well, the keyhole isn't stuffed up anyway.
And I can't smell any gas.
Good heavens, you don't say that.
Very strange it was last night. And a look about him the way my poor Uncle Joe had the day he swallowed the rat poison.
But he's just got engaged to my daughter.
Ah, well, that may account for it. I was afraid I'd done something rash.
Frank, what are you doing?
Are you Mr. Barton?
Yes.
I am Judge Carter.
Judge Carter? I'm very glad to meet you. That'll do, Briggs.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Barton, Llewellyn came to my room at 6 o'clock this morning and woke me up. She informed me then that you and she were engaged.
That's not quite the most auspicious moment.
I should say not.
Oh, I should say not.
I had been up very late the night before with some old classmates and had only 1 hour's sleep. Now, Mr. Budd, I want to ask you some questions, and I'm going to ask them to you now.
I think we postponed our talk to some future time.
We could not.
Oh, of course not. Suppose we take a spin in your motor. The fresh air might do your headache good.
What do you mean by headache?
I beg your pardon. I mean my headache.
Well, why not my headache? I'm sure it's a damn sight more of a headache than yours.
My headache begins at the soles of my feet and gets worse all the way up.
Never mind your headache. Get your coat and come along.
Yes. No, I've forgotten.
What's the matter?
I can't get my coat.
Well, why not?
It's in my bedroom.
Well?
I can't go in there.
Can't go in your own bedroom?
Oh, I no.
Young man, what have you got in your bedroom?
I've got some chemicals in there.
Chemicals?
Yes, that's the idea, exactly.
Tell me, do you plan on keeping explosives in your bedroom after you're married?
Well, I know. I don't think that would be necessary.
But surely it isn't dangerous.
Oh, it's dangerous. It's a filtering group. Mustn't be jumped. Even walking lightly across the room might do the trick.
I think we'll make the appointment for some time later on.
Yes, that would be better. I suppose we lunch together at the Cherrywood Inn.
No! No. I was there last night. I don't like the Cherrywood Inn.
What was that?
What was what?
That noise!
Noise? Oh, yes, the explosive, of course. I'm expecting things like that off and on all day long.
Goodbye, Mr. Bond. Llewellyn informed me that she would be bringing her mother here later on.
Bringing her here?
I shall head them off, however.
Yes, do. It wouldn't be safe for them to come here, really.
I may consent to let Mrs. Carter go. On second thought, I shall say nothing to Mrs. Carter.
Come in.
Hello, George. Are you here early?
Oh, yes, very early.
Oh, well, Jimmy said you'd invited us to the country club for luncheon.
To the country club? I did,
oh, of course you did.
Well, sure.
India rubber face.
Ladies, this is Judge Carter.
Ladies, Mr. Bond, my daughter told me you led a very retired life.
So I do. Why, I'm a modern Diogenes, always in my tub. She'll tell you.
Well, I'm sure I have no idea how much time you spend in the tub.
I so figuratively. Come in.
Especially you.
dropped on me at once. Your breakfast is all laid out in the dining room, sir.
Breakfast? Oh, I'm so hungry.
You are always hungry. This roll of looks like ham omelette, sir.
Oh, how I feel I'm going to be awfully rough with that omelette. Well, come on, Georgie. Come on.
Oh,
make a dangerous combination.
young lady in my bedroom.
A young lady in your bedroom?
Yes. Have you any objections?
Yes, sir, I have. I've been brought up respectably.
This is quite respectable. I abandoned my room to a young lady in distress. We must be kind to her.
We? Don't drag me into it, sir.
Good morning, Georgie.
Morning. Where are your clothes?
I thought I would have to wear an evening dress, but I found this lovely breakfast jacket. Oh, wonderful man. You seem to have everything. Why, there's enough in that little bag of yours to equip a bride.
That'll do, Briggs.
Yes, sir.
Oh, Briggs. Go into the dining room and tell those girls that I have something very important to attend to and mustn't be disturbed.
Oh, Briggs.
On second thought, you'd better lock the door on them.
Yes, sir, I
understand.
Who are they?
No, just some noisy girls Jim promised to take to the country club.
Oh, and he told me I was the first girl he'd taken an interest in.
Ha! Compared to Jim, Solomon was a woman hater.
Well, that's the idea. Is he trying to clear me and boost your own stock, eh?
Oh.
Good morning, Jimmy.
Good morning, Jackie.
Oh, pretty early in the day to be carrying a package.
A gown.
A gown?
A gown for you.
Oh,
well, I figured you'd have to have something to go at it besides that evening dress.
Oh, how thoughtful of you. Isn't he thoughtful, Georgie?
Thoughtful, eh? That's a knee slapper.
Well, why the scornful chuckle, little bright eyes?
Jimmy, have you found out who Toodles is?
No, but wait. I have a clue.
A clue?
Yes. This was picked up after the smoke of the battle was cleared away at the Cheerywood Inn.
And what, my friends, does the Stars and Stripes stand for? It stands... Well, this is total speech!
But how do you know?
Elementary, my dear Watson, element!
Great Scott! Those are the missing papers!
And with them, I am prepared to confront the villain!
Ah, but how will you find him?
How? The honeyed word! The meaning smile! Just leave it to your Uncle Sherlock. Change of environment is just what you need. Well, Jackie and I will help you shift your chattels, won't we, Jackie?
Certainly.
You know me. When it comes to packing, my motto is Excelsior. Funny stuff, George.
Yes, brother. I should perhaps begin.
down by the Quakers.
Oh, George!
By whom, may I ask, are these?
These?
I'm Molly.
I'm Rhoda.
I'm Annie.
I'm the Ava.
I'm Bertha.
I'm Virginia.
I'm Lotta.
And that's who we are!
That's just some friends of a friend of mine, Jim Marvin. Where is Jim?
Come us to the country club!
Yes!
Yes.
Yes.
I have to prepare my speech.
Oh. Hi, guys!
If you didn't have the job.
I do so want to know the judge better. Oh, really? And I should like to know you better. Much better.
Yes, I'll have to tell you all about Auntie as soon as we have time. My memory is awful, it's true.
Not about it!
Well, never mind. Now's the time.
Why, of course it is!
To show some Long Island hospitality.
You bet!
To show all you round town today, we all be gay during your stay.
With the friends and friends and friends, show all of the
morning.
and I was to lock her up until he got back. Now I've got to find him and tell him she's escaped.
Escaped? You talk as if she was a tiger.
Tiger? A crazed ostrich is more like her. Anytime the dentist wants a fan at her teeth, he'll find it on my arm.
Hey, maybe it's the same one as assaulted me. Give me a description.
Rather pretty eyes.
What color?
Same color as mine.
I see. Watery blue. Ears?
Same as mine.
Aeroplane ears. Now, color of hair?
Same as yours.
Hair, a rich, beautiful brown.
Well, call it off the
weather. Oh, now you won't find Mr. Buddy there. Oh, that's the ladies' swimming pool.
Ladies' swimming pool? Well, don't you think I'd better take a peep just to make sure?
Come here.
Something tells me it's my duty, and it would be your duty to run in after me.
Ah, shucks. The swimming pool ain't in use today.
No?
No, I just looked.
Oh, no.
Something funny going on here.
What are you going to do until they hand out the Polo Trophy?
Well, I don't know. I feel at such a loss without the boys around.
Hey, where are the boys? They just left us flat by the tennis court.
Yeah, isn't it so typical? Why, and I'm wearing my new frock. You know, the country club just isn't much fun without a boy around to flirt with.
Oh, Bieber, you're just man crazy. You should find some activity to occupy your mind.
Oh, Bertha!
Don't be such a flat tire.
Hey, kid! Guess what I found in the ladies' powder room?
You'll never guess. It's too wicked.
Well, what is it? A box of Muir Rat cigarettes.
What?
Are you kidding? This kid's everybody!
Oh!
Oh my God! Here's the
My jammies are yours.
Constable, please.
Oh, that's all right. We're all married folks, ain't we? Took my eye, those pajamas, didn't? Told Mrs. Sims about them. She says she'd like to have the pattern.
Oh, all right. I'll get it for you. Can't you find those tickets, Ducky?
I can't seem to remember where I put them, love.
Do you know, Constable, my husband is the most absent-minded man in the world.
Oh, that so?
Why, yes. He thought he'd left his watch home just now, and then he pulled it right out of his pocket to see if he tried to get back and get it.
Here they are.
Oh, how many people are there? Oh,
I don't know. Let's see. 34.
I might as well go. I can see I'm a trifle superb.
beautiful, of course, but the boy is young, so very young.
You imply that a man's morals may improve with age? That hasn't been my experience.
I'm afraid I haven't any time for this discussion right now. I've got to write my new speech.
Isn't your child's welfare more important than your silly old speech?
I'm not talking about my silly old speech. I'm talking about my silly new... my new speech. It must be done in 20 minutes.
Well, it's very careless of you to lose the old one. But you know that all you have to do is mention the dear old club and the polo victory and let the cheers fill up the pauses.
Now, I wish you were going to make this speech. You've got such an unending flow of language.
What do you mean?
Nothing! Nothing!
Nothing. Judge Carter, I'm glad to see you. There's a young lady in the next room who is very anxious to meet you again.
Cut the young lady's stuff.
Good morning, Mr. Bond. Oh, George.
How are you? I didn't see you.
Tell me, who is this young lady who is so anxious to meet the judge again?
Just an admirer of his. That is, an admirer of his speeches.
Of my speeches, yes.
I fancy she'll be able to admire the one he's to make this afternoon.
My God, I shall be making one at all this afternoon. My headache is growing steadily worse.
In fact, she has one of your speeches, Judge.
She has?
Oh, hello, George. You're here. We expected you and that sweet aunt of yours to call on us.
Well, we meant to. You see, but Aunt Penelope is such a retiring little body, and not used to parties.
She has evidently not spent much time in your society.
But she has. She brought me up. We used to say my prayers on her knee every night.
I thought you said she was younger than you are.
A woman seems so much older.
I haven't noticed it.
George, let's go out and watch the girls' badminton match.
Hold it! For the present, Llewellyn, I have decided that it will be best for you and Mr. Bond not to continue your acquaintance.
Oh, my mother, please!
Until such a time as I have had to become better acquainted with Mr. Bond, his mode of life, his morals, and his own.
Why, Mrs. Carter, my life is an open book.
What's my dear? As our greatest poet so aptly puts it.
I am talking, honey bunch.
In the meantime, we'll kindly refrain from addressing Mr. Bud should you meet him.
Yes, Mother.
Mr. Bud, I will expect you to abide by the same rule.
But darling, if they won't.
James, I speak for both of us.
Of course, Mother girl. You certainly do.
Any communication you wish to make to one another may be made either to the judge or, more preferably, to myself. I'm now going into the tea room, and I feel greatly in need of a little refreshment.
Me too.
You understand, Llewellyn?
Yes, Mother.
Nothing.
Your mother's right, you know. She's always right.
Daddy, dear, please.
You mean anything I wish to say to Llewellyn, I must address through you.
Exactly. I trust you write a clear, legible hand.
Well, then I'm going to begin right now. Please tell George for me that whatever Mother says, I love him and trust him.
Llewellyn!
Yes, Mother?
Will you say to Llewellyn that, however dark the outlook, my heart is still warmed by the thought that she has faith in me.
I don't know how much more annoying me.
Court wine in the bank. Oh. Got prescriptions last night. I
Is that all?
And a rabbit's foot.
What were you packing? A trunk? You're a department store buyer.
I am a female in distress, appealing to your chivalry.
What would you have me do?
The policeman I helped you tackle grabbed my bag. My bag contains the articles I mentioned.
And you want me to get it back for you?
Oh, you are a bright boy, Julius.
I'll not deny that. But how can I?
Well, that's for you to puzzle about. It's your fault I got in this mess. Now you have got to get me out of it.
So you will give me my speech in exchange for your bag.
You grasp the scenario of the grammar.
But, my dear, don't you think it would be much better if you were to give me my speech first? Free from anxiety, my mind would be better able to wrestle with the problem.
And of course, I could trust you.
Look into my eyes. Look into my eyes.
What have you got in your eyes?
I have but one fault.
Yes, well, so has the dime with a hole in it, but you know what that's worth.
I'm too honest. Too ridiculously honest.
Good, if you're trying to find out what size gloves I take, they're sixes.
Oh, now you're going to give that speech to me, won't you, little girl?
Ha! I seem to be intruding. Do you love this old man?
This is the old man I was telling you about. Toodles.
Please.
No, it's all right. You can trust Jimmy.
Well, if you insist, I'll go and seek out the constable and try to get around him. I shall ply him with refreshment. Generous liquid refreshment. I have little hope, but still a drowning man will clutch at a straw.
Especially when he's drowning his sorrows.
It's no use. Troubles like mine can swim.
Why did you let that creature claw your hair?
Oh, well, repugnant as it was to my modest, girlish nature, I endured his caresses that I might win his help in my dire predicament. Oh, what we girls suffer!
Let us flee from this scene of degradation to some happier, sunnier clime, to some peaceful land.
Oh, Jimmy, stop, stop! Remember, I have a romantic nature, and you are carrying me away!
To Capri, where the olive trees are decked in bloom. There, upon the hillside, we'll watch the evening stars rising above Sorrento.
Oh, and the petals from the orange blossoms. Tell me about the petals from the orange blossoms.
Yes, Cleopatra.
Tell me about the petals from the orange blossoms.
I know, what's the idea? We're not married yet.
Oh, Jimmy, the young bride dreams of resting on the scented slopes of Italy, and then wakes up to find herself hitting the hay in Flatbush.
Oh, Flatbush, is there such a...
my monkey pig.
Understand it. What a chap she
Well, do you, Pajama?
Well, I wear blue on Thursdays.
Yesterday. today was Thursday.
And they're embroidered with forget-me-nots.
Oh, George's favorite flower.
George? But who's George?
George Bob. The nose?
Well, of course I know George. But what has he to do with me?
That is what I fear to ask.
Here's the handsome waiter, lady.
I think you'd better take that outside. I'm afraid of this woman.
Well, if George has compromised me, he shall repair the wrong.
Is she crazy?
I think it's them drinks.
Oh, that's the idea. Well, girls will be girls.
Yes, they certainly will.
My poor misguided George. This is awful. It makes my head swim. Oh.
Thank you.
what I'm a fan of a tad for, you see. Very high-waisted, Dad. And I guess I better call her on the phone and get her measurements.
Georgie, I just found... Why, Constable, what have you got there?
Oh, the bag belonging to that female has assaulted me.
Oh, how interesting.
Yes, I'm examining it for clues. If I can't trace her from this, my name ain't Ivor Sims.
I wonder if you can. Ooh.
What's that?
A pin.
Pin? That's funny.
What's funny?
Oh, this rabbit's foot here. The lady that owns this bag is superstitious, too.
Oh, why, I'm not superstitious.
Then why'd you pick up that pin?
Pins are worth money. Why, I know a man that makes $6 a week picking up pins.
Gosh, how can he make that much?
He works in a bowling alley.
Ah, shucks.
Hello, Jackie.
Oh, hello, Jimmy.
Judge Carter's just presented me with a polo trophy.
My aunt is here.
named after each other. The one you sat on is my great aunt from Scranton, Pennsylvania. A good creature, but a little touched up here.
She seemed very level-headed to me.
Yes, I never sat on a head myself.
Nonsense.
That's the wife of Jim